All right, welcome back. So I'm going to take a 5 minutes break, and then I'll continue with this. So grab yourself a drink, a coffee, snack, whatever. I'll see you in five. All right, I'm back. Oh, seems like you guys are naming the characters as you see the slideshow. Yeah, as you can see, I draw a lot of all kind of characters from comics to games to anime. All right, so let's add some colors to it. Yes, Carol-chan, I'm here. And you don't have a profile picture. I don't talk to anyone without a profile picture. Just kidding. Find the white color for the hair. I think this will work. Yeah, that looks good. So, did you guys manage to find your favorite character in my slideshow? Hello to Brazil. You love seeing the Android from Dragon Ball Z. Great. Okay. I wonder who was trolling me. So I'm leaving out some white part for the really bright specular reflections, or you call it the highlight for some of you. And then I filled it with slightly lighter orange. From Mexico, good morning. it's important that when you ink hair, especially when you use a brush tip, Copic markers or any kind of markers, always paint according to the flow of the hair. I appreciate all the love icons keep popping up. Definitely in this challenging time, I need some love. Hello, Lisa. Seems that I have quite a lot of students here. Okay, I think the hair is pretty all right. Let me find a lighter tone for that. Yeah, try not to leave too much white on your drawing. If not, the image will look messy. Okay. So as you can see that when I have the gray underpainting done, so when I overlay the orange, that will create very interesting or at least different shade of tones with the same orange. That will help make the image a lot more dark, three-dimensional without actually using a darker orange to do so. So it's kind of a dirty trick or quick way to bring in some tones without bring along too many Copic markers or use too many Copic markers. Right, and then we have the blue. I think this blue should work. Yeah, I look forward to see you at convention again as well, Sebastian. I miss traveling so much, you have no idea. I even found myself losing quite a bit of my motivations to draw this year because of the COVID. I'm sure some of you will feel the same way. I mean, if you are those kind who like to stay at home anyway, or more introverted, then this won't be a problem for you. You just uninstall Dota so that you can draw? Oh, wow. That's a big commitment. I've not played Dota for a long, long time. Did my live stream paused? Is it still moving? Yeah, it's still moving on my side. Oh, it's ended. That's strange.